Hello everyone, welcome back to Code Enzyme. And in this video, I just wanted to show you how you can host your Telegram bot on Vercel. So yeah, just open your GitHub repository and go to vercel.com. Go to add a new project, and yeah, we will select project and import your Telegram bot, whatever your repository name is. Just click on import. And you can name your project anything, and then you can copy your environment variables. So we have this in the environment variable. You can just type it out. What is this? Okay, we don't need that. And once your environment variables are set up, once you have entered your environment variables, you can just click on deploy. Now let's wait for this to finish. So our bot is deployed now. Let's go to the dashboard, and yeah, so it will give us a link. So this is the link for our Telegram bot. And now if you go to api/webhook, you will see that method not allowed. So basically this link is what is our webhook link. So let's just copy this, and now you can go to now we can go to our Thunder client, and let's choose this. And in here I will simply change the URL to the new URL and click on send. So this will set the webhook, and now I can open my Telegram and we can normally chat with it. Okay, so let's see if all the commands are working or not. So let's say first to the start command, and since this is the first time, it might take some time for it to load, or maybe the Vercel is slow. I did not receive anything, so why is that? Let's check. In the logs, there should be some logs, right? Okay, we have some internal server error, and why is that? Failed to send message description not found. I'm not sure why that is. Maybe the environment variables were wrong. Okay, so the environment variables were not set up correctly. Let me just put my environment variables here. Okay, once you have added your bot token, we need to redeploy it. I'm not sure why this happened. It should have been correct when I did that, but yeah, I can just redeploy everything now. Okay, so the deployment was successful, and let's try it once again. We don't really need to set up the webhook again. So what we can do is let's just try this command again. Start command, and yeah, now we are receiving messages, so the bot is hosted. Let's try these commands one by one. So with the help command, we get the same response. With the ping command, we get a pong message, and if I click on cricket, I should get the cricket news one by one, right? So we have New Zealand, and it stops at this point. And why is that? Why does it stop at this point? And let's see. Okay, so this is the problem with Vercel, that it does not, I don't know what to say, but yeah, this is one of the problems with Vercel. Maybe it took to process this this API more than 3 seconds. No, it did not take more than 3 seconds. I'm not sure why this is happening. Ideally, it should be able to send me all of the commands. Okay, let's see. You can increase the timeout function. Okay, so hobby plan, we can make it up to 60 seconds. So that is good. But how do I configure it? Okay, so we have to export this from our route page. And this is for, I think, the Next.js app router. What about the page router? Okay, so we have to do this in the API. Now for the API, where is that? In the webhooks. So pages API in the webhook. I just need to export this, and I will make it the max timeout to 60 seconds because that is the maximum you can get out of the hobby plan. Okay, so this is for the free tier. And now, since we have this, now what can we do next? Do I have to export this for every function? Different running maximum runtime and indefinitely provided this initial response within 25 seconds. Okay, so I need to give, provide an initial response within 25 seconds for sure. So what I can do is maybe I can just send this response before these commands, or maybe not. Let's keep them like this and see if it starts working or not. So let's say test commit. And see if it works. Okay, so we can see it is building, and let's wait for this to finish. Okay, so it is done now. Let's try to do this again. So we have logs, and I think there is a Vercel is restricting me, and that is why I'm not able to fetch the all make await more than once, right? So let's see why this is happening. Yeah, so I increased the timeout, and now I was able to get all the, I think I was able to receive all the messages. Yeah, so we just had to increase the timeout to receive all the messages. Let's make the start command again and see if all the commands are working. So help is also working, ping is also working, and I think cricket we just tested out. So let's try the cricket command also. Yeah, so first series. Okay, so I did some research, and what I found was that when I was using data.map, it was giving me these errors that it was getting stuck on and saying that connection timeout, but this for loop might help. So what I did was I just changed from data.map to this for loop. Okay, so it is the same for loop, but I just changed it from map.map to for loop. I'm not sure why this is happening, but it was just intuition that it might fix it. So I did this. Now let's try to commit this. So I just say from .map to for loop, and let's try to commit this. Okay, okay, so now that this is done, let's try to query from our bot. So let's say the start command, and let's just try the cricket command. So now we are receiving all of the cricket news one by one. So I'm not sure why that happened, but yeah, sometimes using different kind of for loop also helps. Okay, so I hope you were able to deploy your bot successfully. And if you did, kindly like this video, subscribe to the channel. If you have any more doubts, you can tell me in the comments. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you.